Andy Warhol is famous for his silk screens of famous actresses. The following exercise shows users how to imitate this visual effect using Photoshop layers, blending modes, the brush tool, and colors. Before we get started, locate and open data file warhol.psd. Once you've done so, go to the Layers panel, make sure that the face layer is selected, and then change its blending mode to hard light. This is going to create a more stylized look. Afterwards, hold down the Control key and click on the face layer's layer thumbnail to load it as a selection. Click on the Layer menu, scroll down to New, and select Layer. Let's name this new layer Color, then click on the OK button. With the Color layer selected, let's change its blending mode to Multiply. Afterwards, click on the Edit menu. Select Fill. Then in the Fill dialog box, click on the Use drop-down arrow and select Color. In the Color Picker dialog box, select the flesh tone color. When finished, click on the OK button. Click on the OK button again. Then select and deselect. Now let's color the rest of the face. But before we do, make sure that the color layer is selected, and then click on the Lock Transparent Pixels icon. This will ensure that the color stays on the face and doesn't bleed into the transparent areas of the layer. Let's click on the Brush tool from the Tools panel. Make sure that in the Options bar that the mode is set to Normal. Let's also check the brush's diameter and hardness, and make sure that the hardness is set to 0%. The master diameter you can adjust as you're coloring the face. Let's change our foreground color, a reddish color to use on the lips. Click on the OK button, then back on the canvas, click on the zoom tool, and zoom in on her lips. Let's go back to the brush tool and color her lips. Remember that the left bracket key on your keyboard decreases the brush size and the right bracket key on your keyboard increases the brush size. Remember that we lock the transparent pixels, so don't worry about your brush accidentally moving into the transparent area of the canvas. After you're done, let's choose a different foreground color. Then select OK, then brush that color on her face where you'd like. Let's select a different foreground color again. Select the OK button. And this time, let's give her some eyeshadow. Let's change the foreground color again. And color the bottom of her eyes. I'm going to give my face a little blush and select a darker flesh tone. Click on the OK button. Then let's apply the color. Remember that you can add any kind of color to anywhere on her face. It's totally up to you.